right, guys, I am back one more time before the end of the night. I just wanted to come back on because I see a few of you guys are a little afraid of the high ticket video that I did a couple days ago. People were asking about chargebacks and all of these type of situations like that. And I already said, we don't deal with the chargebacks. Like, we deal with our payment processors, or we create them if we have any issues, and we always give them an update on what we're doing. So it's no suspicion going on or anything like that. So, and as far as like refunds or anything like that, the company, the partnering companies that will send the people to, they deal with all of that. You see what I'm saying? So that's what you guys need to realize. Like, you're not going to be dealing with any of that. You take your cut and then you transfer just like if you were doing the other way. I also brought you right here because I wanted to show you what the others are doing. They're called drop servicing, but pretty much every last person on here that you're going to see is talking about drop servicing with fiber arbitrage. Okay. Like I said before, you know, it works. You know, you can make some money with Fiverr and Upwork and all of that. But I always want you guys to be like self-sufficient, independent, and running your own thing, because a lot of these platforms switch up. So it's not me trying to down talk any of these guys on here or anything like that. But a lot of these Fiverr and Upwork, all of these guys, they start switching around their rules to where it's kind of hard to do things sometimes. Like, I did the Fiverr model a long time ago, used to teach it and everything. Like, stuff changed too much. You need consistency. If you want to scale up, you need a business model that's very consistent, where you can pretty much see when trends are happening and you can plan ahead before you get washed off the ship, okay? So yeah, these guys, they're doing good. They're making money. This works and everything. But remember, I want to teach you to be self-sufficient, build your own platforms and have your own way of doing things. All right. Where it can't be stopped. Fiverr can shut this down at any time. Right now is not a big issue, but with everybody sending people there right now with this drop service and fad that they're doing in this way, pretty soon Fiverr is going to start hunting for the profiles. Just like Facebook and Google is starting to destroy a lot of the Google My Business listings because they know they're built by marketers. They catch up to it, guys. They catch up to it. So this is why you want to have your own sites, your own like funnels, platforms, and all of this stuff like that, and not like be putting listings and stuff on these different sites. Okay? I know it's easy because they give you the traffic and all of that, but look, you don't want to wake up one day and your stuff is gone. So I'm going to give you guys, since you guys were afraid of the high ticket drop servicing video, afraid of, you know, drop servicing cars and, you know, private jet services and stuff like that. I don't know why. I'll give you some smaller niches, some niches nobody has ever told you about. If you are an SEO, if you do SMMA, marketing, any type of digital marketing for clients and everything like that, nobody's ever really went through these niches with you before, and that's a guarantee. Matter of fact, you could talk stuff in the comments if you heard these niches before. Matter of fact, you might have heard one. Okay, I give you one out of that, but you haven't heard these other ones. Okay, so I'm very excited to tell you guys about these niches that you can use for drop servicing and service arbitrage. All right, so we're going to go over to Google, and I'm going to show you the first one. I'm going to save the best two for last. All right, I was going to say the best one, but the last two are awesome to me. All right, so the first niche. All right, so just in case you're new and you want to know what is drop servicing, it's the same thing as drop shipping. I consider this a better drop shipping alternative, okay? Drop servicing is you basically, you generate the lead, or a sale for a business, but you take your cut out and then you send the work to them and give them their cut of it. So like if somebody makes a sale through your site or something like that, for, let's say you got a site for emergency plumbers, okay, and you have you marked your services up to like $100 per hour, but that plumber only charges maybe 69 per hour or something. So they pay 100 on your site. You have your virtual assistant accept the invoice from the customer, and they send the plumber the cut, and the plumber gets the address of the job, and boom, you don't have to do any of the work. It's like awesome. It's awesome. You don't have to go out there and do any of the work, own any of the tools, any of the liabilities or anything like that. And hey, it's awesome, right? So today, what I'm going to do is take it down a notch, because I've been telling you guys about private jets, yachts, and all of these big, giant things. You know, well, some of you guys might be intimidated and afraid to get started with that. Well, I'm going to take it down a notch, all right? These are still exciting, and you can still make a crap load of money off of these, especially the last two. Yeah, definitely the last two, okay? All right. So, number one, make sure you guys pay attention and take notes, and I want you to take action. If you watch this, you know that I'm not charging you guys to set up your drop service and sales automation, so you don't have to worry about some pitch at the end, but you do need your materials, your supplies, so that I can help you set everything up so it can run on automation. So, like when you go to a mechanic or something like that, you have to get parts and labor. With me, I'm doing this for real. So you just have to get your parts. We don't care about your labor. We got virtual assistants and staff that can help you set everything up and get you running on autopilot. I don't have to charge you a couple dollars like the rest of these guys just to help you get set up. You get the parts, you take care of the parts, and we'll set up the automations and everything so you can start making sales your first damn week like that. All right, so let's go. Nanny. Nanny services. All right, let's see. Boom. So as you can see, it's 140 searches per month right here. If you want to take it another step, you can do daycare services or something like that. But I like nanny services better. You can even search babysitter. It's all in the same thing. So people will come to the site. They will purchase according to how many hours they need. And boom, like we'll pretty much contact this one of these guys right here. We'll tell them we need a nanny for a particular amount of hours. And we don't do it. You're not going to do it. Your virtual assistant will do it. All right. Or you can do it. You can do it through email. You can do it, whatever. And then you're going to send them their cut. All right. And then you keep the remainder. It's very simple. And the good thing about this type of drop servicing is that a lot of it is ongoing. Just like if you you can rank on Google for a staffing agency. And let's say you get jobs for people. All right, like a staffing agency works like this. These bigger companies and corporations and stuff, they'll come to a staffing agency when they want to hire temporary employees. All right, and that staffing agency gets paid every hour for each employee as long as that employee stays on with that company. And then if they come on permanent, it's even more. Do you guys understand? So think about that. So you could rank for staffing agency, even though I don't have that one on here. There you go. You're welcome. All right. So nanny services, that's number one on the list. It's super easy to rank for. The reason why I went after these, because a lot of you guys don't have a lot of money to get started up and don't really know SEO to rank or any of that extra stuff. So I'm trying to take you to niches that get high call volume, that's not hard to get calls for and sales for or rank for. I'm trying to help you guys out. Give me a like for that. Right. All right. So the next one we're going to go to, I told you these are different. Comedians. All right. Let's see. Comedians. All right. This ain't the city we want. Let's see. In Atlanta. Let's see. We're going to find one with high search volume. 90, or we could say comedy. There we go. Boom. All right. So like comedy clubs and stuff like that. They got the Laugh Factory right there. As you can see, that's 2,400 searches per month. That's a crap load of searches. So you can just charge for tickets. You can contact through email. A lot of you guys are afraid to make calls and stuff, even though you're not selling nothing. You ain't pitching nothing. This is your business. But you can just find out what's the price of admission and can people buy online. That's all you need to ask. You don't even have to tell them what you're doing. You just message through the email. You say, what's the cost of admission? And can people order online? They say, yeah. Then you put the price, you mark the prices up on your site or funnel or landing page or whatever, or Facebook page if you don't have any of that stuff. All right. So it's literally that easy. And comedy is no SEOs, there's no marketers. These guys aren't marketers that's like trying to rank for comedy. Why? Because the SEO can't figure out how to monetize this right here. They wouldn't know what to do ranking for comedy. Well, now you do. Think outside the box. So you can use this niche for drop servicing. Very, very simple. Very simple. Okay, so you rank for that. And you can rank for comedians if you want to, you know, because some people want to just hire one comedian for, you know, maybe for like parties or corporate events and stuff like that. And that one would be easier to rank for than comedy in Los Angeles. So it's just super freaking simple, guys. All right. And I'm going to have a bonus for you too, maybe. Just make sure you stay to the end because you ain't seen nothing yet. Baby, you ain't. No. All right. Let's go here. Watch this. Mobile DJ. Mobile DJ, Los Angeles. Okay, I don't like Los Angeles. Los Angeles sucks. Let's see. We can just put DJs, but I know it's going to be extremely competitive in Los Angeles. So we'll take Mobile DJ and go to another city. Sorry, if you're in Los Angeles, that's going to be competitive for you. So let's go to Atlanta. Go to Houston. Take that mobile off. All right, we got 90 searches for that. We're going to say, I bet you more people are searching for this. There we go. Wedding DJ. There we go. Wedding DJ. 320 searches per month. Like, hey, if you Latino, you can even capitalize on that. Houston DJ Latino, right? All right, so look. 320 searches per month. Let's go to one of their sites and see if they have their prices on the sites. Because I want to just show you guys that this works and what you can do. Let's see if they got their prices on the site. Services. Most places like this have an hourly rate. This site is new. DJ. I don't like this site. Okay, yeah, that's why it's loading so slow. This damn thing is super cool. They try to put too much on it. Anyway, let's see. The quicker way would just be to contact theirs and see how much. All right, here we go. Pricing. They got pricing. DJs and photo booths. There you go with another niche, photo booth. Okay. Man, these fools said pricing and don't even have pricing on here. All right, well, let me make it clear for you guys. I say clear like I'm from the East Coast. I'm from the Midwest. All right. Most of the time is like $120 an hour, like in the Midwest, I've seen for like a typical DJ. You know what I'm saying? It's around that price. So do what you will with that. Okay. I was trying to find one that had their prices listed so you wouldn't have to contact them. Let's move on to the next niche. All right. This next niche, you might have seen the movie for this. Yes, I get ideas when I watch movies, guys. You better keep your eyes peeled, man. That's how you capitalize on stuff. You better keep your eyes peeled. I get ideas from billboards when I'm riding past, commercials, a comedian making a joke or something. I'm like, whoa, that might be a good niche, or that might be a nice strategy. A cartoon doing something goofy. I wonder, can you translate that to real life? And I get all philosophical with it, and it's meant to be a cartoon or something. You guys better start thinking like that if you want to be innovators, okay? All right, for real, for real. I know, but the weirdest people change the world, all right? So you got to be like that. Don't say, ah, that wouldn't work. I'm pretty sure they thought a cell phone wouldn't work either. Now you're carrying it around. You're looking at me through a computer. Plastic piece of junk. When computers used to take up a whole room not too long ago. You guys understand? So don't think something won't work, all right? But I ain't gonna start preaching. Let's see. Yeah. 1 second, y'all. All right. So, you guys seen the movie for this next one. I know you have. It was like one of the biggest movies of the year. It was actually good. It was actually good. Let's check it out. I don't even want to tell you, man. I know. Okay. Scary. Escape Rooms, Los Angeles. Boom. Watch this. Okay, let's see. Let's see, Las Vegas. Might have to take the damn scary part off. It was some city where I think it was super easy to rank if you had scary on the front. So we'll just take scary off so I can show you how the full effect. Boom. 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 Tell me you can't get a couple $1,000 off of that. Just in case y'all want to know what this tool is, because I'm just going like you're supposed to know. It's keywords everywhere tool. It used to be free, but it's you can get like a whole year's worth of searches for like $10. Okay. But anyway, it's worth it. It helps you scope out your campaigns when you're trying to rank for something, doing SEO and stuff organically. Excuse me. As you can see in Las Vegas. Escape room. See, before that movie, I didn't even know that this was an actual thing. This ain't something black people do. I'm just going to let you know, right? And that's good because nobody like knew about it as far as SEOs. Now you can literally clean up like in this niche right here. Escape rooms. Las Vegas gets 14,800 searches per month. Okay, so you probably think it's extremely competitive. What I consider extremely competitive is those searches with more than 20, 30 freaking pages. Boom. This only has one page. Can I move this over? Yeah. All right. So as y'all can see, this only has one page. One page of competition. Meaning even if you make a listing and rank like in the middle of the freaking page or something like that, you're still gonna get visits to your site and everything like that. So you can sell tickets to the escape room. And after that movie, the searches for this then blew the hell up even more. So you just find out their prices, just like I said with the other and all the other niches. You can go to their site and see if they got them. Buy tickets as a gift. See, you can buy tickets on the damn site. Do you guys understand how powerful this is? Because I just showed you something that you can pretty much rank with for free. Look at this. $100 gift voucher. Boom. So you can sell it. They're selling it for $100. You can sell it for $2. And they'll still buy it for the experience. On top of that, you have the irresistible offers that I give you. All right. I give you access to the ability to be able to give away free vacations, free restaurants, food and things like that, all different types of gifts and stuff like that. So you guys are going to have that ability to be able to do that. So as you can see, you have everything you need. You can pretty much just copy this page, get you a website builder, go to, Builderall, or go to the link in the description, sign up at Builderall where I'm at, and get one of the drag and drop landing pages. Like, pretty much just copy this. You can even snippet this. Like, sometimes when I don't feel like being all creative with creating websites, this is what I do. Watch this. All right. So let's say I told them that I'm going to be sending people to them. All right. And I want the site to look pretty much identical to theirs. So I would just use this snipping tool right here. And I would just do this. And the whole page would be image or a clickable image to their freaking website or to my payment buttons and stuff. So after they look all over and I put my prices on there and everything like that, they could just click pay and all of that and book the ticket, blah, blah, blah. I didn't have to do any crazy graphics or anything like that. What the hell? Okay, close out. Close out. I don't want you, man. All right, so that was just a little hack right there. If you're trying to get like landing pages to look identical to another place that you're going to be sending people and everything, just use the snipping tool and just upload it as an image. You know what I'm saying? And boom, full screen it. Boom. So as you can see, you can book tickets from the site. Let's see if the other one allows you any of the other ones allow you to book tickets from the site. These damn contacts is acting up. Okay, let's see. All right. Everybody got their little movie version and stuff since the movie came out. See, the site don't have to be all that. It don't have to be all that, but this is like a cult type entertainment type deal. Like, people will pay to go to these because it's an experience, especially since the movie, like, people were like scared as hell. So as you can see, look, you can pay on, they got all different types of rooms and stuff, and you can book the time and everything. You can just literally copy this on your site and you can just like hit one of these and look, buy gift card, redeem, blah, blah, blah. Basically, you can steal the price from them and then mark it up a couple hundred bucks. That's what I would do. That's what I would do, man. So I'm just showing y'all some niches that nobody else will be in. If you want to start drop servicing right now, nobody will be in the niche for nanny services. And I just told you, like, this don't have to be a one-off. With the nanny services, you can literally be getting paid for years off of each person that comes in to be a nanny. Years, because like nobody says, I just want somebody for this weekend, that's it. If it goes well, they want somebody to watch their kid for a couple years while they're at work. Like a couple years, like most nannies grow up with families and stuff like that. So this is a whole new income stream for you that can be like for years. And that's nanny services right there. Now, of course, it's not high ticket like the private jets and everything I was showing you guys the other day, but it will add up over time and everything, and it's easy, and it's something you can start today, and you can even run Facebook ads for this and target women that just had kids. Very simple. New parents. Very simple. And you'll just fill up on this. Like, I'm just trying to tell y'all, man. All right, and then the comedy. You can sell tickets. So I've pretty much been on the road today with the selling tickets on from the site thing. And then just people already got the address, so they just go there, right? Okay, so I know. Okay, so you might be saying, David, what about when they purchase the tickets from you and then they actually go there in person? Well, when they purchase the tickets in the follow-up email, they're going to get notified that we're a partnering site and they're going to go to the actual place. All right. And the reason we were able to charge more was because we got the traffic, first of all. But secondly, we got the irresistible offers. We're giving the giveaway gifts. We're going to give away the free trips, the restaurant vouchers for food, rental discounts, and all different types of stuff so they can have a full event that night and not just go out to the comedian thing. So it's like way more. Yes, they can pay cheaper on the actual site, but they're going to get an experience through all of our bonuses, all of our bonuses. You see what I'm saying? So that's why they'll pay more and won't have a problem with it, even though the regular place might be cheaper. The regular place ain't giving them no trips out of town, right? Okay. So then we talked about the mobile DJs, and you guys already know about that. A lot of you guys have booked DJs for your parties and homecoming and freaking graduations and corporate events and stuff. So you know DJs get paid. All right, so you can just mark them up. I would suggest marking them up 80 to 100 bucks over what they're doing. So if they're doing 120 an hour already, then you can mark it up to 2 or 220 an hour and just say you're luxury, okay? All right, and give away the bonuses to whoever books. That's the good thing about having connections and being able to give away bonuses, right? All right, because they'll pay more for that because it's going to be an experience. Then we just discussed one of my favorite, which is the escape room. Nobody on YouTube, Google, nobody that teaches SEO or SMMA, nobody has ever told you guys about this niche. And you might say, well, David, maybe that's just in Las Vegas. You know what I'm saying? And another thing, you don't have to be in these cities. I don't know how many of you guys are watching this and you're new to marketing or something. So you might be like, I'm not in Las Vegas. That doesn't mean that you can't show up on the internet. Like on the internet, you don't have to actually be from a place to show up there. It's different. As long as you can prove to Google through marketing that you're local to that place, then you can show up there. All right. So a lot of these guys have an address. They have an address in Las Vegas, meaning you can get addresses in Las Vegas even if you're not there. You see what I'm saying? And be able to do marketing and show up here. So let me just prove to you that this is not the only place. Yeah, let's go to Los Angeles. Let's see how much in Los Angeles. 8,100. Let's see if any other cities got it. Let's go to Chicago. Midwest, let's see. We don't really be on stuff like that, but let's see after that movie. Whoa! It just backflip kicked me. It just said, Ryugit on my ass. All right, that's 22,000 searches per month. 22,000. Now tell me you can't make some money off of that. That's like paid traffic, but free. See, that, you see where I got the idea from? That's a keyword here in Chicago, scary escape room. That's why I had it on the sheet, but it ain't everywhere. All right, so now let's see the competition. Let's see the competition, because maybe it's different in Chicago. Boom, one page still. A lot of you guys are like, oh my God, man. If you know anything about SEO, you know that usually it's about, you ain't even got to know about SEO. When you go and search something, you come down here, it's usually about 20, 30 different pages with a whole bunch of different businesses. You only got a few businesses that you have to beat out. That's it. By the end of the week, you can at least be in the middle getting some sales. All you have to do is have the irresistible offers using profit positioning like I teach you guys. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go watch the rest of all the drop servicing videos I've been dropping the past week and a half. Go drop them and you'll see profit positioning, how I give away the free vacations, how I give away the free food vouchers, the moving, the different services, the fun, all of that stuff I'm able to just give away on top of the experience they're going to have there. That's why they'll choose me every time over any of these, I was going to call them losers, but the rest of these dudes. And that's 22,000 searches per month, brother. That's super powerful. And guess what? You can do this in multiple cities. Nobody's stopping you. That's the whole point. Once you get it working in one city, just think, I want you to add the money up in your head. Once you get it working in one city, you scale out. Everybody scale up ads. I scale up cities. Imagine that. Okay? So you can look. We can keep going. Let's see. I'm from St. Louis. I don't think it's there. I definitely never heard. You know, I don't live there no more, but I definitely never heard of no escape room when I was there. You know, so let's see. Okay. Wow, 5,400 searches per month. So as you can see, this ain't no little ass niche. This ain't no baby niche where I don't get no searches and everything like that. This mug is low competition everywhere we have went so far and high traffic volume. This is a dream come true for any marketer watching this right now, any real marketer that can be a little bit creative with how to monetize things. You should be like, oh, thank you, David. Thank you, David. Thank you. That's what you should be like. Bow down. All right. So let's see how competitive it is in St. Louis. Because I did not know it was one that's on. That's a good sign. Whenever this is long, pause. Whenever this is long right here, that's a sign letting you know it's definitely only one page. Let's scroll down. Boom. One page. They can't even fill it up. Google ain't even got enough businesses to fill it up. So that means you make another one, you should probably pop up like around here somewhere for free without even doing any like real strategic marketing and everything. Even if you just name it this or St. Louis Escape Rooms, exact match keyword, but you want to be careful. That's why this one is ranking so high, because it's exact match. All right. But you want to be careful because Google is starting to shut down exact match keyword. Google My Business listing. So you want to put a little bit of branding on it, kind of like this, No Way Out Escape Room. You know, me, I would say St. Louis Escape Rooms and Fright Fest, or some St. Louis Escape Rooms and Scary Mazes, or something like that. You want to add some type of branding on it, some type of like extra extend, you know. You can't just say Escape Rooms St. Louis no more. Like, they're going to start getting to it. But in niches like this, it might take some years because, like I said, this ain't a hot niche where Google is like, go get those marketers. Marketers ain't talking about no escape rooms. You're welcome. Okay? So, I said I was going to save the best for last, but yeah, truthfully, man, I love escape room, man. All right, but we're going to go ahead and talk about this one. Are you guys ready, man? Are you ready, man? Like this, man. Subscribe if you're new to the channel, because I'm about to open your mind up to one of the best freaking niches with the highest amount of call volume, with the lowest amount of competition known to SEO, man. I'm about to give you that right now. Man, I expect, man, just... I ain't got nothing for sale, but y'all need to just start sending me PayPal payments. Let me look at my phone right now. It should be some pay, because I'm about to give you something that, okay, watch this. I'm gonna just cut to the chase. And it don't matter what size city we go to, you're gonna see some type of searches for this. Now, let's go. And it's gonna be low competition. Los Angeles, yo, skydiving. As you can see, let's try another keyword. Boom. Okay. So 210 searches per month if you put the CA behind it. But if you take the CA off and it was just skydiving Los Angeles, it was around 5,400 searches. Boom. Remember I told you when this is long, that means it ain't no competition at all? Wow. Psh, psh. That's it. That means you're automatically going to rank somewhere near the top just by creating the listing. And why? Who can guess why he's ranking number one? Is it because he got all these reviews? No, it's exact match keyword. In the year 2019, it's probably not going to be like that this year. But in year 2019, we was ranking a lot of stuff for free without spending no money on SEO or doing anything strategic just by doing exact match keyword. And it was getting us like number one, number two for a lot of stuff, man. Like, that was the year. I hope you guys ain't miss out on 2019. Maybe it's still going to be like that now. But okay, so my point is this. Skydiving is a crazy easy niche, and it's super fun, and people love experiences, so they don't really think. This is one of those irresponsible spending niches and stuff like that, where people just, they don't care. They just want to have fun, so they just spend. Whatever the price is, they just spend. All right, so let's see if we can find one that got the prices on it. Okay, so hey, yo, type something in the comments if you like think this is like one of the most creative niches anybody told y'all to go to. All right, let's go to rates. All right, so this is a service. So we're drop servicing, okay? So let's see. All right, boom, here we go. Here we go. Here are the prices. So if they book online, they pay $249. If they book over the phone, they pay $299. If they pay in person, which we don't want them to do, they pay $249. So we want them to either pay by phone or online. Why do I say by phone? Because once you guys are set up and you make a little bit of money, you want to get somebody for the phones. All right. So that they can be accepting payments on the phone and it could just go right through super smooth and you don't have to wait for nothing. Like, this is business, man. And it's easy. You guys can have this. You can just go into this niche right now, be set up by the end of the week, actually profitable without even really putting any money into marketing at all. Because every city that I'm going to show you is literally open for skydiving. And I just gave away my niche, man. I feel like, wee. All right, let's come on. So you guys saw the prices. And I had a bonus for you guys, right? All right, let me see if one more I have. I like to see at least three of them that maybe show their prices online. That way I don't really have to contact them and stuff like that. All right, let's see if anybody got their rates. Deem a voucher? Maybe. I don't know. It's easy. These are niches that don't get contacted by marketers. So, like, if you send them an email, like, when I used to do, like, try to get clients and stuff like that, and I would call niches like this, they would be happy to hear from me. Like, and that's something different because, like, in the marketing realm, like, when you cold calling and stuff, it's scary. Like, it's very scary. Like, people don't want to, like, hear from you. So when you cold call them, they're like, what the hell do you want? What the F do you want? Stop calling. Get a real job. Blah, 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 this. They go off on you. You know what I'm saying? But, hey, in niches like this, they don't get calls because SEOs don't know how to monetize something like this. The SEO think in their mind, like, they're not going to pay me because it's not going to be hard to rank. Ranking ain't the only way you can get people, some new people. First of all, you can do Facebook ads. You can do Wrangler's voicemail blasts. You can do other organic. Even if they're ranking on Google, they might not be ranking on Bing. You can still do that. Even though they're ranking on Google, you can get them more traffic from YouTube. There's a lot of things you can do. So SEOs need to open their dang own mind and be creative. So as you guys can see, they have one of the prices on here, $159. I will bump that up to at least $259 or $3, to tell you the truth. That's how I am, because I'm going to give the bonuses. Now, if you're not going to add any bonuses, I would just bump it up to $259, not $200, $259, okay? Because you want to at least get a $100 profit off of it, right? All right, so let's move over. All right. There was another one I just had an idea to show you guys, but now I can't even freaking think about it. I can't even think. Okay, so we had skydiving, escape room. What was the other one, man? I had a bonus for you guys. I should have wrote it down. I wrote the other ones down, but I ain't write the bonus down because it came to my mind. while we was doing it live, all right, while we're doing it right now. So let's see. Skyline. Hey, you guys might have to wait for the next video for that one. I thought I had it in my head. Like, okay, it could be hot air ballooning. Maybe it's that. Jet skiing. Well, I'm just telling y'all a lot of niches that y'all don't know about. There you go. Take hot air ballooning. Take jet skiing. Like, let's see. Watch this. Let's see if we can get some jet skis. Jet ski rental. Pretty much all the rental companies like is high ticket. Matter of fact, I'll show you that. I just had it and lost it again. Okay, but yeah, you can do jet ski rentals. Okay, while I got it, here we go. Scuba diving. Freaking certification. All right, scuba diving certification. Let's see. Take that one off. All right, 590 searches per month. One of these, I saw their prices on there. All right, so you can get like certified, like one of the high packages is like $2,000 for like a master certification or something like that. And I was like, oh my God, I had no idea. This stuff is extremely expensive. All right, let's see if they got the prices still on here. We'll just click on one. See if they got the prices. Come on. Okay. Open water course fee is $357. Okay. So you can see their prices on here. And I know y'all ain't heard of no damn scuba diving certification niche before. And as far as marketing goes, let's see. Become a professional diver. I'm trying to find the one that I saw on one of these sites that was like 2,000. Okay, let's click on that one. Open it up. They're not telling us, man. It must be super expensive. Okay. Where is the one that I saw, y'all? This one I saw that had like $2,400 or something like that. Trying to show that one to you just so you know. Just so you freaking know. It must have been a different site, guys. But you just saw one of the prices. But damn, that's not the one I wanted. I wanted to show you the main one. Like freaking like crazy. I was like, wow, what? Okay. Why would they have the prices for that one and not have prices for the rest of them? It don't make no damn sense. Professional training. This sucks. All right. Well, you guys can come over here to Orlando and look at these sites if you want to and just go through them. I'm not going to go through all of them and everything like that. Let's try one more. Ranger Rick. Try one more. See if we can find the prices on here. Diver courses. Damn, they make it hard. That's what I'm saying. You guys can take over in this niche. They make it hard to find the damn training, man. Let's see. Like, I know they ain't getting no damn sales. It don't matter where they ranking it. All right, so this one is 99. You would obviously rank that. I mean, bump that up to 200. I'm going to open it up. I ain't got time to be going back. All right, let's see. And this one is... Where is the price? Once again, they don't have the price on her. Do you guys see the price on her? Well, they show you the price for the first one, but don't show you the price. Let's open up. Okay, let's go advance. It was one of these that had like a family package, and it was like a huge package. I was like, damn. All right. Still no prices. Anyway, you guys can come through. I gave you the keyword. You can just search scuba diving, and mainly in places that's by the water and stuff like that. It's in the Midwest some places, but it ain't really going to get you no like high call volume, because who the hell in the Midwest really want to go skydiving, scuba diving and everything like that. So try to pick places like Florida, California, Hawaii, you know what I'm saying? Places by water and things like that. Okay. So that's pretty much what I wanted to come back on here, because I've been showing y'all the high ticket stuff, you know, a lot. And some of you guys have been afraid of that, you know, afraid of making moves like, man, that's a big purchase, man. Damn, man. You know, it doesn't matter. These people are searching. I'm teaching to go after things that people are searching for. They know how high the prices are when they search for it. The good thing about Google traffic is people search with their wallets already ready on Google. Like, they search like, okay, let me go and get this. Like, you don't really like, you know, you go to Google for research and you go to Google for purchases. That's it. You can go to YouTube and Facebook for BS. But on Google, you go for like to make purchases mainly. Google and Amazon. Okay. So now you guys have, I gave you, I was supposed to only give you five freaking niches, but I ended up giving you around like 10 if you were paying attention. Rewind this, watch it over so you can get those. All right. Pick one or two and go hard, like scale those up in multiple different cities, and you'll start seeing crazy results. A good thing about drop servicing and how I'm teaching it to you guys is that you can scale it up like super fast. Within 3 months, you can be past $20,000 a month. All right. So I'm telling you, and depending on what niches you go after, if you go after the high ticket drop servicing niches, like I was talking about in the other videos, then you won't even be waiting no 3 months to get the six figures. Because if it takes six hours, if someone books a private jet for 6 hours and that costs $48,000, you see what I'm saying? That costs $48,000 on, I think that was a mid-size, or was it a light? A light. Either a mid-size or a light jet. $48,000 just for a 6 hour flight. That's that private jet stuff. And the good thing about it is private jet is super simple and easy to rank for. The calls start coming in. You don't even need a million calls. Because if you can put $3,000 to $5,000 over that $48,000, a person that's paying $48,000 won't know the freaking difference. You think they're like, no. I thought it was only going to be $48,000. They're in a different mind state than somebody buying baby bottles for cheap on Amazon. They don't give a damn about chump change. You guys understand? So this is why I teach you how to go after the high ticket stuff, the yachts, the luxury jewelry, like hip hop jewelry and different things that's outside the box. Don't go after all the niches that everybody else is going after. Lawyer. Chiropractor. Those things work and everything like that. But it's super competitive, whether you're doing drop servicing, whether you're doing SEO, whether you're doing pay-per-call, it's still competitive to get paid traffic for those, and it's competitive to do free traffic for those. But with these drop servicing niches I've been giving you guys, it's literally a ghost town when it comes to marketers. I've been racking up without any signs of slowing down or saying, I never got to a city and said, man, there's about 10 SEOs here. This is going to take me a year to rank. Never. If you just open your mind, right? Everything that has a beginning has an end, yo. This video has an end.